Hello everyone, welcome to my class today. Today we'll see the next medical surgical nursing topic, that is lung abscess. So lung abscess is the complication of the pneumonia which we saw in the last class. So when you see lung abscess, the definition is it is a necrosis of the pulmonary tissue and formation of cavities containing necrotic debris, pus and fluid in multiple areas of the lung. So you see this is the lung, and in the lung you can see the pus formation which forms like a cavity or a pocket, that is called as lung abscess. So abscess means it is a localized pus collection. Lung means, and so it is lung, so the abscess are formed in the lung, so it is called as lung abscess. So necrosis means the area dies because of the inflammation, irritation and decay of the tissue is called necrosis. So pulmonary tissue goes for necrosis and they form cavities. Cavities means pockets like this. And these pockets will contain necrotic debris. Necrotic debris means whenever microorganism enters our body, our antibody will act against this microorganism. So both microorganism and the antibodies, they fight each other and at last they die. So that cell which dies, those dead cells are called as debris. And these debris along with the fluid, they form like a pus, and fluid all will be present in multiple areas of the lungs. Okay, and these pocket, when we measure, it will be more than 2 cm in size, then it is called as lung abscess. Okay, next coming to the causes of lung abscess. Okay, causes of lung abscess. So lung abscess mainly it can be caused due to aspiration. So in the aspiration cause, so aspiration can cause because of any absence of gag reflex. Gag means swallowing reflex. Okay, when the person's swallowing reflex is absent due to some diseases, then it can cause lung abscess. Okay, so first is any periodontal disease. So periodontal disease means any infection of the tooth and the gums. So when person is having any infection, tooth, decay, gums, this oral cavity microorganisms, they can enter inside the lungs. Okay, and then it can be due to any diseases like seizure disorder. Seizure means fits, where the person, when he is having fits, accidentally the saliva and secretions can enter inside the lungs. Or it can be due to alcoholism. Okay, so when person is taking too much alcoholism, again his mental status is disturbed and thereby he can aspirate the secretions. Okay, and then patient is having any drugs like general anesthesia. Okay, so when we give general anesthesia for the person, again patient's consciousness is lost. So at that time patient can aspirate the secretions. Okay, and any CNS means central nervous system disorders like stroke. Okay, so like stroke can cause. Stroke means there is decreased blood supply to the brain. So because of that, patient can go for unconsciousness. That time his swallowing reflex will be lost. Thereby he can aspirate the secretions. Okay, so any conditions, if the person is aspirating the secretions, then the person can go for lung abscess. Okay, the next is secondary cause. Okay, so these all are primary causes. Okay, primary cause means it is due to aspiration, the microorganism directly goes into that area of the lung and they cause infection. And next is secondary cause, that means there is some other cause because of that the person is going for lung abscess. So the secondary causes are, first is pneumonia. So pneumonia means already there is a bacterial infection in the lung, and this infection, when it is going to complication, that means person is not treated with antibiotics, he can go into the final stage of complications where the inflammation and irritation occurs and they can form like localized pus collections. Okay, so pneumonia. And next, any malignant tumors of the respiratory tract. Okay, so in the bronchus or any area of the lungs, if there is any tumors or malignant tumors. So these tumors are abnormal tissue which grow in the lungs. So because the tumors grow in higher sizes, the mucus which are secreted in the lung, they cannot be cleared outside. So when the mucus is not getting cleared outside, all the mucus will stay inside the lungs and they start colonizing bacteria, and thereby person can go for lung abscess. Okay, so this is primary secondary cause. Okay, and next it can be due to any bacterial or virus, sorry, bacterial cause. Okay, the bacterial cause is, there are so many bacteria, so it can be a aerobic bacteria or an anaerobic bacteria. Okay, some of the aerobic bacteria is Staphylococcus aureus, Klebsiella pneumoniae, Nekardia species, okay, and the bacterioids. Okay, so these are some aerobic bacteria which can cause inflammation, and there is also anaerobic bacteria. So aerobic means those bacteria which live in oxygen, and anaerobic bacteria is those bacteria which can even survive without oxygen. Okay, so in anaerobic bacteria there is microphilic streptococci. Okay, and some species of Staphylococcus and the gram negative bacilli. Okay, so these are all aerobic and anaerobic microorganisms. So whenever microorganisms enter inside the lungs, they can cause inflammation and infections of the lungs. Okay, next, coming to the pathophysiology of lung abscess. So due to aspiration of microorganisms like anaerobic or aerobic, so most common in lung abscess is anaerobic bacteria, and also aerobic bacteria can cause. Okay, so these anaerobic bacteria, they are found in the oropharynx. So when this anaerobic bacteria is aspirated, the bacteria go and adhere into the lung walls. Okay, so they go inside the lungs through the bronchus, they enter the lungs and they adhere, means they stick to the walls of the lungs. Okay, and here there will be release of inflammatory mediators and macrophages. Okay, this, whenever any microorganisms enter our body starts produce chemicals to destroy the bacteria, and bacteria also produces chemicals to destroy our body. So these are inflammatory mediators which are released from our body. Okay, so when these chemicals are form, they start inflammation and irritation of the lung parenchyma, which is the initial stage, that is called pneumonitis. Okay, so patient will first go for pneumonitis, where there will be inflammation and irritation of lung parenchyma. Okay, after pneumonitis, there will be formation of liquefactive necrosis. Liquefactive necrosis is due to the inflammation and infection, there will be so many chemical mediators produced, and also the fluid from the capillaries and the cells will be released, and these all form like a liquid inside the lungs. Okay, and that area becomes like a necrosis, means decayed tissue. Okay, and later stages there will be development of circumscribed lesions with necrotic debris called cavities or abscess. Okay, circumscribed means there will be a formation of a localized area where this necrotic tissue, cellular debris, the pus, everything will be collected. Okay, that is called development of circumscribed lesions. Circumscribed means there will be a particular area where the lesions will be present, and these all will be filled by all this necrotic debris and fluid, etc., pus. So that is called cavities or abscess. So there will be formation of cavities or abscess, that means pockets. In the pockets there will be pus and other decayed cells, and around these cavities or abscess the clot and scar starts formation. So there will be deposition of fibrous scar tissue around these abscesses, which will cause necrosis of the lung tissue. Necrosis means death of the lung tissue. So this is the pathophysiology of lung abscess. Okay, next, coming to the clinical manifestation.
ओके।
In clinical manifestations, so because there will be so many secretions produced, there will be purulent, foul smelling, sputum, and sometimes sputum will be also mixed with blood, that is called hemoptysis. Okay, and there will be even there will be distaste or halitosis in the oral cavity. Halitosis means bad smell in the mouth or bad breath. Okay, so bad breath is called as halitosis because of the infection and the pus collection inside. You can feel the bad smell in the mouth. Okay, so halitosis, and due to infection there will be pleuritic chest pain, dyspnea, so that is difficulty in breathing, and cough. So due to increased secretion, patient reflex is to put out the secretions. Okay, and when there is so much infection, patient and also bad smell in the mouth, patient will not feel like eating, so patient will have anorexia. Anorexia means loss of appetite or lack of hungry. Okay, the person will not feel any hungriness, and because of this anorexia patient can go for weight loss. Okay, so no, because patient is not taking food properly, and patient, because it is an infection, patient will have fever, chills, rigors, and sweating. Okay, so there will be excess sweating. This all in order to eliminate the microorganisms from the body. Our body starts increasing the set point, that is temperature set point. Okay, and when you auscultate on the lungs, there will be respiratory crackles. It is an abnormal respiratory sound. Okay, that is creak creak sound you can hear. And also when you percuss on the fields of the lung, you can feel the dullness. Okay, dullness will be felt on percussion. This is because inflammation, infection, and there is fluid accumulation, cavities, everything. You can feel the dullness on percussion. Okay, next coming to laboratory findings. The laboratory findings or diagnostic studies. So first main important for any respiratory or lung respiratory system disorder is X-ray. Okay, so in X-ray you can see the cavities or fluid filled cavities in the lungs will be seen in the X-ray. Okay, sometimes X-ray cannot show it clearly, so you can do a CT scan or ultrasonography. Here you can distinctly visualize the abscess and pockets formed. You can see in the CT scan and ultrasonography. Okay, and then sputum and tracheal aspirate. Okay, if most patients, they will have breathing difficulty, so sometimes patient will be put on an endotracheal tube, or if the person is putting out so many sputum, so these sputum or tracheal aspirate will be sent for culture and sensitivity to identify the growing microorganism. So which organism is growing, according to that the treatment will be done. This sputum, and if this infection is because it is deep inside the lungs, they will also take a bronchial wash aspirate. So this is using a bronchoscopy. They put a bronchoscopy, and through the bronchoscopy they will aspirate the fluid or secretion from the bronchial area, so that because infection is deep inside, you can see. And also one cause I said tumor. So when they take the aspirate, they will identify whether it is a tumor or whether it is some secretion, or if it is secretion, what microorganism is growing. Everything you can understand in a bronchial wash aspirate. Okay, and these patients, lung abscess is very severe, they will progress to a last condition called empyema. Empyema means pus like fluid filled in the pleural cavity. Okay, that means because pleural membrane is very near, the microorganisms can migrate to the transmit to the pleura, so that we have to also take a pleural fluid analysis. Again, this will be sent for protein, LDH, that is lactose dehydrogenation level, and albumin, and then culture and sensitivity. All these tests has to be done. So whenever there is an infection, protein, albumin will be LDH level will be increased. And in culture and sensitivity, again you can see the defending microorganisms. Okay, so these are the tests you have done. Okay, otherwise for seeing the oxygenation, you can see ABG. So in ABG, SaO2 saturation will be decreased, and PaCO2, that is sorry, PaO2. PaO2 is partial pressure of oxygen. This will be decreased. This shows hypoxemia because in the lung fields in the place of oxygen, pus like cavities are filled. Okay, so in blood test they will do a ABG, and also WBC test will show increased leukocyte count, which means patient is having infection. Next, coming to the management of lung abscess. So because it is an infection, so the main treatment will be antibiotics. Okay, there are so many groups of antibiotics. So initially we'll start with metronidazole, clindamycin, doxycycline, penicillins, ampicillin, motifloxacin, and the very potent drugs like vancomycin, linezolid, and cotrimoxazole. Okay, so these all the drugs, they will anti group of antibiotics based on the patient cultural sensitivity reports, which drug is patient is sensitivity, they will give the group of antibiotics. Okay, and in case of fever, you can also administer antipyretics like paracetamol. Okay, so antipyretic can be given in case of fever. Otherwise, supportive therapy will be given, supportive therapy like oxygen with mask or ventilator and CPAP. Yeah, according to the oxygenation of the lungs, any method of oxygen administration can be done. Okay, and again, same like anything, you have to, in case there is excess secretions, we have to give a chest physiotherapy, suctioning or nebulizer therapy. And in case there is copious secretion and tumor which is present inside the lungs, you can also do a bronchial wash. Okay, bronchial wash is they put a saline solution or antibiotic solution and wash the bronchus, so that if there is any microorganism is there in the bronchus, then it can be removed outside. Okay, so these otherwise nutrition, you have to give patient increased protein and more of fluids, that is liquid diet will be administered. Okay, so because patient cannot digest very solid foods, and also due to bad taste etc., patient will not feel like eating, so small fluids will be given. Okay, and next is coming to the surgical management. So in surgical management, there are lung sparing procedures. Lung sparing procedures are segmental resection, so that means which is removing the segment of the lung. Okay, so removal of the segment of the lung. So there are, the lobes are again divided into segments, so removing the segment of the lung is called segmental resection. Or they can do a lobectomy if the abscess is formed in a complete lobe. Okay, so this is removal of a lobe. And in case of patient has severe and it is multiple abscess are present in all over the lung, then the only procedure is pneumectomy. Pneumectomy means it is removal of the lung. Okay, so it is pneumonectomy. Okay, pneumonectomy is removal of the lung. So these are the procedures done in case of lung abscess. So because there is two lungs, patient can also respire with one lung, but the survival rate is very less. Okay, and these patients should follow strict strict hand washing and hygienic measures at home. So because any infection can get transmitted because they have only one lungs, and it is necessary that we have to protect the lung. Okay, and when patient is going home also, sometimes patient may go with the oxygen therapy, and you have to also teach the patient how to be careful when he is handling the oxygen cylinders, etc. And also if the patient is going with nebulizers, then we have to teach how to use this nebulizer therapy. Okay, otherwise all the post operative management as usual for other patients. I hope you understood the class. If you are interested, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.